आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द सब्जेक्ट नेटवर्क एंड साइबर सिक्योरिटी प्रेजेंटिंग बाय मंजुनाथ अय्यर असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ईसीई डिपार्टमेंट कैनरा इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज फ्रॉम मैंगलोर.
So this presentation will have the details about SSL protocol, sorry, alert protocol and SSL handshake protocol. So in a previous lecture, okay, so we had discussed about SSL record protocol and SSL change cipher specific protocol. Okay, so other two remaining protocols in the SSL are these two, okay, SSL handshake protocol and SSL alert protocol. So we have to study about these two protocols in details so that so our study about SSL will be complete after we are studying all these four protocols: SSL record protocols, SSL change cipher protocols, and SSL handshake protocol and SSL alert protocol. So next topic is very important to understand: SSL alert protocol. So before we get into the SSL alert protocol, so let me explain about connection and session, how it will start. Before client is communicating with the server, so they have to authenticate each other. So like they have to understand each other, then they have to trust each other. Okay, so once they have trusted each other, the communication will be start. Okay, so while during understanding between the client and server, okay, if there is any mischief behavior, okay, if any the mistake has happened, so it will come to the conclusion that so whatever client is communicating with the server, so it's not a genuine, okay, either client is not genuine or server is not genuine. Okay, so how they are going to authenticate each other? By sharing many informations like certificate and MAC related information and some algorithms related to the encryption and compression algorithm. So once the everything has set, so they'll come to know that so we can trust each other and they can start communicate each other. If any one parameter is not able to come to the conclusion, or it is failure to understand each other, so it will say that either the client or server, they are not legitimate or they are not genuine. Okay, so then we have to be alert. Okay, either server have to be alert that I am not communicating with the right client, or the client have to be alert and saying that so whatever server I am going to communicate, so that is not a legitimate or the right server. So now getting into the topic, exact topic, SSL alert protocol. So conveys the SSL related alerts to peer entity. Okay, peer is nothing but end-to-end entity. So what is the severity? So there will be warning or fatal if any mischief or malicious things has happened, okay, while understanding between the client and server, so it has to send a warning or fatal signal so that both they can alert. So there are two alert protocols. Again, the set of rules. First one is level, and second one is what? Alert. So level information is given by 1 byte, so that's a 8 bit, and alert is information is sent by again 1 byte. It's nothing but 8 bits. okay, through the 8 bits combination, it will send an alert message to both client or server, okay, anyone. So let me talk about the alert. Okay, so we have to be alert when we come to know that so data transmission is not being safe, so which we are communicating through internet. So first one is specific alert. So there is a fatal and the warning. The fatal parameters is related to what? Unexpected message is received, or when bad record MAC. So message authentication code, information related to the message authentication code is failed, then it's a bad record MAC. Then during the decompressions, if they are failed to decompress it, so which means the data which we are sending to the recipient is not a valid recipient, because you don't know what is a algorithm that we are using during the encryptions. So only if he is a genuine person, he knows this, what is a decompression algorithms is used, because it is shared between the sender and recipient. If any other person or unauthorized person is coming between is and is trying to what decompress it without knowing the algorithms, so that indicates that so unauthorized person is trying to access our data. Decompression failure and handshake failure, okay, and illegal parameters, some illegal parameters when exchanged between the server and client, it indicates that so there is a fatal alerts. So warnings are not going to cause or impact so much, but we have to be very careful, we need to be alert. So when the fatal things are very severe, so we have to be very alert. But warning, okay, so some extent we can give some excuses, but we have to be alert. So immediately when notification is closed, when there is no certificate is exchanged between the client and server, so sometimes for a bad service the certificate will be not exchanged between the server and client, but both the server and client, they are trusted, okay, they are genuine or legitimate server and legitimate client. But because of some issues, they are not able to share the certificate. So that time we can give some excuses, but we need to be so alert. Sometimes certificate is exchanged, but there is a bad certificate. So details about the certificate, I have already told you that the certificate name is X509.V3. Okay, so that certification details is not up to the mark. So bad certificate is being exchanged. Unsupported certificate sometimes is exchanged. Certificate revoked, certificate expired. So like we have a certificate, let's say for example license, two-wheeler or a four-wheeler license, it will be expired and we need to renew every time. Same thing with the communication also. So certificate will be expired and the certificate have to be renewed every time. So if it is failed to renew, so we can consider that so whatever the data is communicating between the server and client is a warning, so that we can give some excuses. Certificate unknown certificate is exchanged. Okay, so all these parameters will become under what? Warning. And where we are facing the problems related to all this, we cannot take these issues in a severity, but we can give some excuses. Server or a client may be genuine, but because of some reasons it's got failure. So again it will encounter for next verification. So next, compressed and encrypted like SSL data. Okay, so these are all comes under what? SSL protocol, alert protocol. So which means, so we need to be alert. So before, so we are communicating with the server, okay, between the client and server. So perfect understanding, so when there is a perfect understanding between the client and server, then the connection will be established, then session will be established. So else no, it will come to know that someone third party is trying to access our data. So next, okay, as we move on to the next topic, SSL handshake protocol, we need to study. So handshake protocol is having or it's carrying some information, okay, related to what type and what's the length of the message and the content. So content is greater than its information, okay, it be carried by greater than or equal to 0 bytes. What's the length of the message is carrying is that information is, okay, given by 3 bytes. That is 3 into 8 bits. Type of a message, like what type of, okay, message we are sending. So its information will be given by 1 byte. So now let's see one by one. Allows the server and the client. Okay, handshake protocol. So many times I told you that. So before we are like a client is connected to the server, client is connected to the server, okay, our server is connected to the client, so they have to trust each other by sharing some information. If everything is set, then the connection is established and session will be start. Okay, one day one, both they have to trust each other. Server has to trust the client and plus client have to trust the, okay, server by exchanging some information. So it's like a handshake, okay, handshake protocol. So allows the server and the client to authenticate each other, like they have to, okay, understand each other and they have to give the authorization to each other to communicate, to negotiate encryption and MAC algorithm. To negotiate means to share the information about the encryption, which algorithms were used for encryption and which key has been used for encryption, whether it's a private key or public key, and which algorithms, okay, we have used at the, or we are used during the encryption. All this information have to be negotiated with the client and server. So message authentication code, so it's a secret code we are using for the private key. So that secret key have to be shared with the client. Okay, so all these parameters have to be satisfied. So then when the connection will be established. So it means what? So client is sharing its what information with the server. So that if anything mischief behavior or any malicious behavior is happened, okay, from the client side, so we can easily identify that. So it is done by okay, so which client. So that's why all the information you have to be shared with the server, okay, by the client. So that's why, so most of the times, okay, hackers, they are not, without sharing all these informations, they are going to attack. So because of, we don't have that satisfactory, okay, security. So without sharing MAC and without sharing encryptions, okay, so they are going to hack the system. So that is what actually, so the professional hackers, they will do it so that we are not able to track them. Okay, we are not able to track them. So they don't know how, so the hackers, they know, or they have that idea about without sharing all this information, how to steal the data. So they are all professional hackers. To negotiate cryptographic keys, okay, to share the cryptographic keys, okay, to be used during encryption and decryptions. So have to be, okay, shared between the client and server. So the connection will be established. So if anything is bad has happened okay from the server side, the client will come to know. If anything bad is happened at the client side, so server will address, or server will come to know that this client has done, okay, so this bad malicious, okay, things. So next comprises a series of messaging phases. Establish security capabilities. Okay, we need to establish the security capabilities as much as possible. Server authentication and key exchange. So there is a secret key is exchanged, secret key of server and secret key of client have to be exchanged between each other. So at least not private key, at least a public key, okay, should be exchanged between each other. Client authentication and key exchange. So client secret key, sorry, public key have to be exchanged. So then it will say it's a finish. So actually handshake protocol is we are going to perform with four stages. In a first stage, establish the security capabilities. In the second stage, server authentication and key exchange. In a third stage or the third phase, client authentication and key exchange. And so then, so at the three stage when it is succeeded, so fourth stage says that it's going to just say that okay, so we can establish the connection. Say by saying that, okay, so job is finished. So we'll study in detail about these four stages in next slides. So next handshake protocol will be performed in four stages or four phases: phase 1, phase 2, phase 3, and phase 4. Okay, so totally four phases are included in handshake protocol to understand the client and server, each other. So one side we are having client and another side we are having a server, so they have to be authenticate each other, they have to trust each other. The first signal will be sent by client to the server. Okay, let's say for example we want to send a signal, say hello message. Okay, so that message will be sent by client, hello message to the server. The server will receive. Okay, so server will again send the acknowledgement saying that I have received the hello, hello message. So in between establish the security capabilities including protocol version, session ID, cipher suite, and compression method and initial random, so numbers. So these are all the things have to be shared between the client and server. So in phase 2, so in phase 1, so before we get into the phase 2, so let me explain one more point in the phase 1. So it's a dual communication. So a client will send a message to the server, so it's trying to say that I want to send a message like hello. Server will give its response to response back to the client saying that yes, I have received your request, to say to receive the message hello, or to send a message hello. So in a phase 2, so before the connection have to be established, so it has to trust the client, right? So it will send a certificate to the client. Certificate will be shared and sent by the server to the client, and the server secret key will be exchanged with the client, and the certificate, the request, it will say, it will ask for the request to the client to send its certificate, and then it says that yes, the server allow, request has done. So now the server may send certificate to the client, key exchange, it's a secret key be exchanged with the client, and a request for the certificate. So it is asking the client to send the certificate. So that is, I think, X509. Okay, V3 and server signal and hello message as okay, face. It's a single side communication. So only the server in the phase 2, only the server is sending a okay, signal to the client. Okay, with the for the certificate and okay, server key exchange and other things. So now phase 3. Okay, now phase 3. So it will receive the certificate from the server, then it will send its certificate to the server. Okay, this certificate will share from the client to the server, and the client okay, public key will be exchanged, not secret key, the private key. Okay, public not okay, it's not going to share the its public private key, it's going to share the public key, and it will say that yes, have verified your certificate which I have received. So your certificate is shared, no? So it says that yes, certificate is verified and it's a valid certificate. So it will again send an acknowledgement to the server by client. So it's a single hand communication. So only client will send okay, information or acknowledgement to the server. So client sends a certificate if requested. Okay, client sends a key exchange, and client may send certificate verification. Okay, it will send its certificate for verification. Next, in phase 4, change cipher specification. Okay, it will say that that the cipher has to be changed from okay, pending state to okay, current state. Then it will ask for the finished job. Then it receives all these two information received by server, and server will again give the acknowledgement to the client. Change cipher specification as done, and finally it says that yes, the job has finished. So in phase 4, change cipher suit and finish the handshake protocol. So handshake protocol will be performed in okay, 4 phases. Each phases okay, in each phases okay, so there is a particular task will be done. Okay, particular task will be done. Phase 1 is dual communication, phase 2 is single communication from the server to the client, and phase 3 is a single communication from the client to the server. Again, phase 4 is dual communication. Okay, so this is very important topic to be understand, and in point of your exam. Okay, so many times the question has appeared okay, from the same topic to explain what is handshake protocol. So now we are going to discuss about in detail. Okay, so what exactly is the phase 1? Phases. Okay, it's about to establish the security capabilities. First, it's a version. The highest SSL version understood by the client. The highest version of okay, SSL version. So usually, the highest version of SSL version is SSL. Okay, V3 I think. SSL V3. So they keep on updating. Okay, and they'll give some name for the updated version. So random, a client generated random number, so which serves as okay, nonce. So a client generated a random number for the fragment, so it will be, the server has to be nonce. Session ID, so once the connection is established, each user may have single session or multiple session. Each session have to be identified. So it is identified by a variable length session identifier. A zero value indicates that the client wishes to establish a new connection on a new session. Okay, so if a zero okay session ID is having zero okay value, indicates that establishes a new connection for a new session. Cipher suit. So this is a list that contains the cryptographic algorithm. Okay, so for each fragments we will encounter for encryptions technique. Okay, so then the ciphertext will be sent. So while we are encountering for encryptions, we have to use a specific algorithm. Okay, so then we are able to convert what ciphertext. So cryptographic algorithms, what algorithms we are using for converting plain text to ciphertext. So compression method, so we need to go for a compression technique if it is necessary. Again, it is optional. If a fragment size is too much, the size of a fragment is too much, so we need to reduce the size of the fragment. Okay, so by using some specific compression algorithm, so we are encountering fragment for the compression technique. So this is a list of the compression methods the client has to support. So next to phase two, so what is going to happen in the phase two? So phase two is basically, as I told you, it's a single end communication from the server to the client. So server begins this phase by sending its certificate. So first its certificate will be sent or shared with the client. So next, server key exchange message may be sent if it is required, so otherwise no. The secret key is exchanged between the server and client for encryption and decryption of a ciphertext to the plain text. The certificate request message includes two parameters: certificate type, so what type of certificate is being used, and certificate authorities. So next, after all these three steps is over, it will say that server has done. Send a request. Okay, so my job has done. So again, phase three is about client authentication and key exchange. Again, it's a single-ended communication. So some information will be shared by the client to the server. Okay, so first the client verifies the server certificate, which is shared by the server to the client in the phase two, and checks whether the server hello parameters are acceptable. So basically, client is trying to send a message like hello. Okay, so it is going to verify that whether it is acceptable or not. So if it is a valid server, it's going to accept. If it is an invalid server, it's not going to accept. Client sends its certificate message. So if the server has requested a certificate, so else no. Again, it's optional. If no suitable certificate is available, the client sends no certificate alert. Okay. Whatever the certificate is shared by server to the client, if it is valid, so then it will accept it. Otherwise, so there is a strong warning saying that, so you should not share your certificate with the server. Okay, that is alert message. Next is the client key exchange message, which has the same parameters as the server key exchange message. It's a repetition, that's it. Client key exchange message, which has the same parameter as the server key exchange with the message. Similarly, the client may send a certificate verify message to provide explicit verification of a client certificate. If there is a request from the server to the client to share client certificate, the client will share its certificate to the server. Okay, so it will ask for the verification. Okay, so because server should know that, right? It has to understand the client and its certificate. So because if anything bad has happened in future, so it will identify the client with the certificate and all. So these are all what we are providing the security, or we are avoiding unnecessary clients or third parties who are trying to access the server. Okay, so client is sharing his information with the server, means he is surrendering himself to the server. okay, by saying that if anything has happened, so it is because of me. So whether if I am going to hack or whether if I am going to do any unnecessary things is happened in the future, so it is because of me. So because it is identify the it is I, okay, if that malicious or mischief behavior is identified, okay, by the server by identifying all these informations like certificate and everything. But hackers are too smart, so without sharing all this information, still they are able to what? Access the some server. Okay. So phase 4 is what? It's the final stage and it's about to give the conclusion. Okay, so once everything is set up, okay, all the information is exchanged between the client and server. So the proper connection is established and session will be start. This phase completes the setting up of a secure connection. So when all these have, okay, phase 1, phase 2, phase 3 is going smooth. Okay, so then the connection will be established in a secure mode. Connection will be established in secure mode. If anyone is negotiating, they are not ready to share the information about the certificate and about the secret key and all. So which means some, okay, suspected client is trying to access the server. So that is how we have to track the hackers. The client sends a exchange, the client sends a change cipher spec message and copies the pending cipher spec into a current cipher. Once everything is setting up, the cipher text has to be what? Shared to the server. So previously it is in pending state, now it will say the say it's okay current state. So now it is ready to share with the server. So moreover, the client then immediately sends the finished message under the new algorithm and keys and secrets. Okay, see about its secrets. Okay, secrets are like related to keys and algorithms. The server sends its own change cipher spec message, transfers the pending to the current change cipher and sends it finished. So now we are ready to send a cipher text and everything is okay going in a proper way. So it will send that, okay, it will send an acknowledgement to the client, okay, from the server saying that yes, I am ready to accept your cipher text what you are trying to send. Okay, so this is all is going to perform under handshake protocol. So hoping that you have understood very well about handshake protocol. Thank you.